after this whole set. All right. And it looks like Starterville. They're hovering and staying over that. Yep. All right, so Blue in 10 going Charizard and Fox versus Moosh and Vash going Captain Falcon and Marth for Losers Finals. Right now, like I said, Vash is having, you know, somewhat of a good start, at least predicting Blue's, at least aerial movements for now. Blue can throw that neutral. I didn't even realize that, but his neutral is a pretty good getting back on stage, like, move. It's kind of like Rob's, but it doesn't have that fire aspect. And Vash gets taken out first stock fairly early, 30 seconds in. Eh. It's nothing that they can bounce back from. Okay, very nice. Moosh tried to connect with that down spike, but Blue was able to interrupt with the up B. It has the hurt box above him, so that connected with Moosh first. Flare Blitz going in on Vash, but 10 gets taken out as well. So, and again, it's looking pretty even. A slight advantage because of the Blue's 10's percentage, because he was just taken out. So he gets a spike, but it's on stage. Air dodge recovery, but he was able to sneak back in. Blue could have gotten a grab off that that shielding, or that Vash, he was attacking the wrong way, I believe. Throw in the Thundercats, didn't kill though, so we get no Thundercats ho, but very nice. Side smash from Blue will take out Vash, and then the up smash from 10 takes out Moosh. And right now it's 5-3, but they're at high percentages, so long as they get in the attacks where they need to. They can be shifted around in any second, like just what we saw with the last match. But already, he has to go for the Sheriff stock option because that was another early take. Vash tries to go for the Shield Pierce instead of a grab. A grab back throw probably would have taken out Blue. He's got 191. A little bit of offstage play here, and Blue still had his jump. Very nice weight. Takes out Moosh with a back air and was able to recover. And now Vash is by himself. One stock against five, but a neutral. Okay, that was, I believe, a neutral from Blue hit 10, if I'm not mistaken. 10 going in with these dash attacks. It's his main, you know, setup for even that dash up smash. But again, Vash thrives off of these circumstances where it's by himself. He has, like, insane patience and insane concentration. Just trying to move in when he knows it's the right opportunity to move in. Gets the shark, able to stop Blue's fire breath. Forget the flamethrower, I guess, yeah. Right now, reset to neutral here. A little bit of jabs getting up damage on him. All right. Good weight. Yeah, very nice grab option from Vash. Now Charizard gets his stock taken, but he's at 96%. A back air from Blue will be able to take it, but they get a throw combo here most likely. No. Able to retreat to ledge. Good roll. Rolls back and forth, though. Tries to get the up B kill, but it was just off the edge of the hitbox, so it didn't connect with the rest of the hits. Going in deep. Very nice weight and recovery from Vash. Getting an up B, yeah, but that left him vulnerable. And a clean up air from 10, and that'll be the first round to Blue and 10. So let's see. In terms of play style, because I don't think they're going to shift off this team. I don't know. It's kind of hard to say. If anything, like, Moosh could be a little more wise to the aerial gameplay. Because Fox is pretty good in aerials, but Charizard's a big, beefy, big character model there. And, you know, if Moosh throws out, like, his up tilts, you know, it extends his hurt box pretty far from, like, his own body. So it should be able to rack up a fair amount of damage, and just overall throughout the match, that should give somewhat of an edge. And so we go to Final D. Alright, this is the, so, let's see, Fox and Charizard won't get, you know, such, Charizard being such a heavy character, I'm sure he has some benefit with platforms, so this was a good pick, at least for Vash and Moosh here, but Marth can do the same thing with platforms as well, so that'll be a disadvantage to Vash as well. So Blue here, you know, just being fearless, concentrating on Vash right now, just not letting him get back on the center stage. Moose is going to have to come in to help him out. He's got to be careful of throwing out those smash attacks, Moosh. You got to be real careful of that. Because that'll leave the fast character of Fox, and Blue is just really adept at just waiting for his right time to strike, almost as much as Vash with his Marth. And Olivia is certainly vulnerable. But first stock has yet to be taken, but there it is right there. Back air from Blue again. And Moosh was trying to get the spike off 10, but the Firefox was able to hit through. Right now, okay, they were able to claim a stock off of 10. So now it's Blue and Moosh sitting at high percentages. He was trying to find his way back in, but 10 just being fearless, going in with that aerial to force him fast fall him with a dodge. And he was able to respond on platform. Moosh able to send out Blue with I believe, a back air. And now Blue, okay, he's actually focusing on Vash because he's seeing 10's having a little bit of trouble. But now he's got a little bit more of control and trying to go in. It stunted out the up B, and yeah, that was just far enough for a second up B to not reach the ledge. Very nice play from Blue there. Yeah. You don't want to throw out the flamethrower when you got your teammate right in front of you. And they're not expecting it. The back throw almost takes out Falcon and had the star animation. And a lot of players are starting to believe that the star animation, if you don't DI when star animation comes out, it will KO. But you have a chance with DI if it does. But not if it was such a heavy hit as that forward air from Blue. And now Vash has his last stock, 89% already as well. But I mean, they're faring actually really, the red team's actually faring a lot better this time around because they have them at high percentages. And so long as they can take these two stocks at high percentages here, it'll be 3-1. But an Earl, oh, a stock take on, oh yeah, and they have to force the share stock. So it evened up just that quick. Back air from Moosh takes out Blue. And an up air from Moosh takes out 10. Very nice. And they even it up just like that. But Moosh has to play very carefully. He should be hanging back. Let Vash do some of the work here. Or at least the majority of the work. But right now he's getting hammered by 10 right now. Throwing out all these tilts and aerials. Racking him up to 52%. Just evening him up comparable to the Blue side here. Spike sends Blue down all the way from almost the top of the stage. And again, any just one move can throw the shift of a match just like that. And 10 is fighting for his life right now. At least to get 2-0, but a clean up smash will take out Moosh. But a second one, wow! You know, great commitment on 10's part there, just running up and up smashing him. I would have been scared to go up against just straight up running up smash against Vash's Marth. But yeah, that was fantastic effort. Fantastic job from 10 there. They're realizing the ridiculousness of what happened just the past two games. Or at least, like, what was it? Semifinals and first round of finals. And again, I don't see... Well, maybe Blue could go Mewtwo. Because, like, he's still debating, like, whether Charizard or Mewtwo is his main... I think. I'm not sure. I would have to ask him if he's actually decided on that, but you know, that's probably the other shift. But then again, Vash is really good at edge guarding. And Mewtwo is difficult to edge guard because of his disappearing act with his air dodges and up B. He just, yeah, the character model disappears entirely, so it's hard to track. But you know, if it would be anybody, it would be either False or Vash there that would be able to do it. And he's actually considering switching to probably Mewtwo or possibly Sonic. I know it's his other one, but do we see a gimmick team? No, we don't. Shifting to Toon Link? No, going to Olmar? I think I've only seen him go Olmar once, if I recall correctly. Shifts all around. Moosh, no, come on. No, don't do this to yourselves. No, you were fine, guys. No. Okay, yeah, we saw this, I believe, 2 Weaver Bears ago. LOF Blue went, Blue went Rosalina along with, I forget his teammate at the time. Well, yeah, they went double Roses. So we know that he has Blue has a Rosa. And Red Team's sticking with their team of Marth and Falcon. That's the better option, I'd say. But in terms of character matchup here, Rosa's easily top 10, I'd say. Just because, you know, it's basically, she's basically the ice climbers of this game. Like, she can hang back and just let, exactly like this, just let Luma do the dirty work. But, you know, Rosa's definitely a force to be reckoned with by herself as well. And she's doing a pretty good job edging out Vash with the galaxies right now, but he's able to respond back. Ten just going ham on Moosh, going wild with these up and just up airs and just aerials in general. And a solid forward smash from Moosh almost clears out Ten off the side, and Luma gets taken out as well. So Blue's going to be without Luma. Sends both up. Vash looking for a shield pierce in the air. It's interesting. And a clean spike from Moosh. Well, it probably wasn't clean. Wasn't watching if it was entirely clean, but it looked clean from what I saw. So, yeah, that'll take out Ten's first stock. But the red team is sitting very high, and Blue has been 47%. Not a care in the world right now. Red team's got to be really careful with what they do. And a Moosh accidental hit because of Rose has sent him into it. Shield pierce almost takes out Ten's shield. Back air will send Blue back. But, you know, she's got good recovery as well. Not, like, the best in the game, but probably top eight, if you're considering. Like, that up B just goes at ridiculous angles, and it arcs, so it's kind of hard to predict. Just like that. I thought she was going to snap the ledge, but she actually recovered on stage, and it just mixed up everybody. And an up smash from 10 will take out Moosh's first stock. And Vash is looking. Yep, he's going down. Too far out. Right now, Vash is putting in work, sending them over the Moosh, who's trying a little bit of difficulty trying to get some purchase of combos off of, especially Blue's Rosa Luma right now. Oh, wow, that last hit of that forward. Accidentally sends Moosh back a bit that he didn't expect. Oh, wow, the Luma didn't hit Vash's grab on 10 there. And I believe that was Moosh that backed through Blue. I could be mistaken on it because I'm trying to focus on the what's on stage. Forward air sends 10 across the stage. Vash tries to respond with a two frame but doesn't get it. 10 gets sent out again, but he recovers back on mid stage. Up air is going to keep out Moosh while Blue tries to work on Vash here. Vash able to get in with, I believe, a back air, and there goes Luma. A little bit of danger here for Blue. Oh, wow! Very nice connection. Yeah, but he suffers for it. Yeah, I believe, I want to say forward air from Fox. I don't see a whole lot of Fox gameplay, but I think it's like one of the last hits of Fox's. Oh, what happened to Blue there? I guess he expected to have the jump, but he didn't. But then he upbeat a certain angle, and he just got Battlefield pineappled. We don't have a term for that yet, I don't think. But yeah. That last hit of that Fox attack, it actually sends the character down with him so long as you fast fall. But, oh my gosh, what an accidental kill. All right, but he gets one of his own. But yeah, that accidental kill takes out Ten's other stock, and now Blue has a very steep hill to climb, especially with that fresh Vash right now, 0% on him. He has to, and yeah, Moosh is doing the smart thing. Because he has 6%, he's letting Vash do the brunt of the work. Trying to find his way in on Vash here, but he gets the grab. But Luma interrupts Vash's approach. And nice wait there by Blue, avoiding the two frame, but he gets sent out anyway. Up B on stage, just missed the sweet spot of that knee from Moosh there. An accidental hit from Vash sends Moosh off the side of the stage here, but he'll get back. And right now, Blue's in the middle of these two, looking for a combo. Good dodge, dodging that back air. Luma gets sent out, though. This is going to be even more difficult. And yeah, these up air from Moosh should tries to go. Oh my gosh, Moosh! I know that it's a very dangerous move, but you gotta be really careful when you use it, pal. Tries to get the spike, but he sends an up air out to interrupt it, and now he's trying to. Yeah, Moosh is really fishing for this spike or just that cherry on top. He really wants this very finesse, very cool kill. And right now it's keeping Blue alive, actually. Sends out a down smash. Oh, but he responds with a forward air. Very nice. Vash had his teammate Mush's back there. And he was able to respond with a forward air, stopping Rose's trying to gimp Mush's Falcon there, and he was able to claim stock with it as well. All right, so this is Losers Finals. All right, so 2-1. So yeah, it's been going pretty back and forth here, and it's been all with just adjustments, no character swaps. So, you know, that's the sign of a very high-level player. When they don't have to switch character, they don't have to pull out their pocket cloud or anything like that. But yeah, it just shows the sign of a very adept player, very high-level player, and it's fantastic that we have these in Losers Finals, of all things. It means Grand Finals is going to be even more hype, whoever goes there. So yeah, this is going to be tournament match for Mush and Vash. Or tournament round, if you want to be, like, actually official with the names there. But yeah, 10 just going in, doing the brunt of the work. You know, Blue's there, he can throw out back airs of his own, like I said. I like teams that have the one character that racks up damage, the other one claims stocks because of the racked up damage. But, you know, it's pretty much on, it's holding true for a lot of the matches I'm commentating. Mush almost gets him with a gentleman, but I think he DI'd downward, so he was able to, or at least backward, probably. Blue just waiting, using that jump to wait for that down air opportunity, down air spike. But Mush was able to snap the ledge just in time. Mush, very nice job of recognizing that Vash was in a little bit of a pickle. Blue was using flamethrower to guard the edge, so Mush just came in with a shoulder tackle. Good forward air, but he responds, and Vash gets taken out for stock. And again, high percents all around, and there goes Mush. But now, just watch out for this blue team here. They're going to get stocks taken as well. Especially right now, Blue's having a hard time getting in. Vash is able to claim first stock on 10. You know, Blue, even at 158, showing he has no fear, trying to go for these down air spike setups. Vash able to shark away Blue's, or 10's edgeguard there. Blue just very patiently just waiting, and I'm surprised to see that Mush isn't trying to help his teammate Vash trying to get recovery there. I thought a shield break was going to happen. Back air again takes out Vash, and right now 5-3. Wow. Okay, I have never seen that in all my years of playing Smash. The up B from Mush was able to clear out Blue off the top of the stage from the ledge. That was just an oddity. Blue going in with an up throw, not enough damage. Oh, wow, but the up B was able to go through Mush's effort to try to stop it and was able to claim Mush's stock there. And we have Blue with the only person with two stocks. And again, he's fishing for these down airs. I mean, he's perfectly in the right to do them, but he's just showing, you know, right now you would usually have the person with two stocks try to hold on to that stock, but Blue is just showing that he is definitely helping out his teammate here, trying to get this these last kills.
I just hit the headset on my head while I play.
Trebby's back with me.
Yes, everyone. I assume, yeah, Grant's... okay.
Yeah. Vash is neutral, right, almost takes out Blue. Flare Blitz.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Flare Blitz fair. Blue has no double jump, I believe. But he's got a B, so he's fine.
Yeah, 10 was close enough that he kept the pressure on that platform there.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, the Raptor boost.
Gonna come in.
Just a slight bit of rage on Charizard's 40.
And up throw almost takes out 10.
This ain't melee. That move has knockback for no reason.
He's going to need a lot of higher percentage in order for that up throw to kill off the platform, because it sends him diagonally as well.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, the up air.
Great.
Going to take Mush out.
Yeah, nice awareness.
So now they're on the okay.
It's
10
losers.
And Blue.
Yeah.
10 and Blue are on the loser side?
Well, they're both on losers.
Oh, so it's a reset. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, no. It's just Losers Finals.
Oh, okay. I got mixed up. Yeah. I thought this was Grands. I'm really sorry.
Yeah, that's all right. It's all right.
You just came I hate looking like an idiot. But well, that's what happens when you come. Oh, the back air will take it. So, yeah, Blue and 10 will have taken this set 3-1, which is not Grand Finals, so it is not a reset. But now they are going to go to Grand Finals and face Luck and Uno.
Yes.
Yep.
That's right. Fine. You just came in. So,
I just came back.